namin sa pag-upload ng mga videos simula nung tumama yung bagyong Rolly dito sa amin and yung mga sumunod na bagyo after that. And natagalan kami maibalik yung kuryente dito sa amin and also the wifi kasi grabe yung damage dito sa amin. And I wanna share the pictures na tinkunan ko a few hours bago lumihis yung bagyong Rolly dito sa probinsya. And let me tell you, devastating yung damage dito sa amin. And it took more than 2 months bago maibalik yung mga kuryente dito sa probinsya. Kasi dito sa first district kasi, dito yung pinakagrabe na damage. And yung kisame doon sa kwarto ko, nasira. And as a result, yung isa sa mga posters ko, nabasa. Napasukan ng tubig. And then, dito sa side na to, nabasa yung isang poster dito. And luckily, hindi itong part na nakikita nyo na serve as my background in all of my videos simula noong 2019. Naibalik yung kuryente dito sa amin last December 23, 2 days before Christmas. And naibalik yung wifi connection noong Christmas Day. So, saktong Christmas na ibalik yung wifi namin. Pero problema, yung CPU na ginagamit ko sa pag-edit ng mga videos ko, sa pag-upload mga videos ko on my YouTube channel, hindi gumagana. Because first of all, ang pagpalit ng motherboard is expensive, 6,000 pesos. So, nag-decide kami ni Papa na hindi namin yun ayusin kasi ang mahal. And pangalawa, nag-generator kami before na ibalik yung kuryente. And I was supposedly record yung isa pang video that was supposedly to upload last December bago matapos yung 2020. Pero unfortunately, medyo hindi stable yung flow ng kuryente dito sa amin. Kaya may times na nagba-brownout dito sa amin. And nung sumapit nung New Year, I suffered from cough, from sipon, may plema sa ilong, yes, and napaas yung boses ko. Because first of all, prone ako sa sipon. And I know na mahina yung immune system ko pag malamig yung panahon. And second of all, umiiral yung amihan season. So, mas malamig yung weather pag January up until February. Kaya every time na sumasapit yung January and February, kailangan ko mag-jacket all the time. And to the point na makapal yung mga blanket ko na ginagamit ko pang tulog. And madali akong nilalamig. Kaya all the time, noong mga days na nagsasuffer ako ng ubo, sipon, tsaka pas ng boses, kailangan kong mag-inom ng gamot, mag-inom ng suwa, as in yung pinatutong na suwa, and water therapy. Kailangan kasi nasa tabi ko palagi yung tubig, and pinapalit ko yung tubig everyday. At least maginhawa yung lalamunan ko. Pero I'm okay now, sipon na lang yung problema ko, because madali akong masipon, kaya kailangan ko talaga ng tubig all the time, para hindi ako mahawaan ng sipon from others na nagsasuffer ng sipon as well. But anyway, now I am back. I'm here to talk about the overshadowed issue na yung isang former member of Topp Dogg na ngayon ay isang chat singer, he revealed that he was being outcasted. So I know na mahaba yung intro ko. So before I start this video, don't forget to click like, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell para maging updated kayo sa mga videos ko, and share the video. So now, the issue about a former Topp Dogg member named Seogoong, who goes by the real name of Park Hyun Ho. He's a trot singer now, and he used to be a musical actor after he left Topp Dogg. So, kung hindi kayo familiar sa Topp Dogg debuted back in 2013, and they debuted originally as 13 members. Madami silang lineup changes all throughout the years, And yung last comeback is back in 2017. Yung isa sa mga former members, I know you're all familiar with this one, ay si Sanghyun, na former member of JBJ and now a member of JBJ95 along with Kenta. Nai-upload yung now-deleted video of Park Yun Ho's interview doon sa YouTube channel named Idol Olympic. And doon sa interview na yon, Park Yun Ho discussed the fun memories with the former members of Topp Dogg and yung isang part na he was being outcasted. So I'm going to read what Park Yun Ho said doon sa interview na yon. And yung video na yon, by the way, was uploaded last December 11. Pero it was deleted a few hours later. So I think sinabi ni Park Yun Ho about the fun memories as a member of Topp Dogg. There were a lot of fun parts and it was great because it was a foothold in the beginning of my dream. So I felt like I had achieved a dream. It would be good if there had just been happy things, but I think I didn't have a good relationship with the members. I thought that it would be a great thing if one of the members were doing well for the sake of the team, even if it weren't me, but that wasn't how it was from a parental perspective. It's natural for parents to all think, my son is the best. We naturally grew farther and farther apart. He later commented in the video that he had thought that him getting attention after showing what he could do was for the sake of the group. He also talked about some of his experiences during their promotions. At the end, I was alone during the recording for the anniversary album title track, and I was also alone on a music video set. I was upset to keep being separated from the others. On the music video set, a van would come with lunch boxes. The others would all be eating, but I was in our vehicle, and I'd eat when they were done. I think they separated us like that because they were worried we'd fight if we happened to meet. Then when I went to the music video filming, I had to pretend to be close with them again. I enjoyed it back then, but when I look back now, I wonder how I managed it. The decision on whether I would leave Topp Dogg or not was made in such a cruel way through a vote with all the members together, including me. It was said, if you want Seogoong to leave, raise your hand. In front of me, one by one, they raised their hands. I get a bit choked up even thinking about it now. It was the worst. Nowadays, our relationship has improved to the point that we say things to each other like, how are you doing? And let's get together and make music. He shared that if he was now asked about potentially getting Topp Dogg back together, he would want to do that. So like I said a few minutes ago, former member ng Topp Dogg si Sanghyun. And noong 2017, he joined the second season of Produce 101, which is the very first male version of the Produce series. And nag-release ng statement yung agency ni Sanghyun. And they said, hello, this is Star Road Entertainment. We are issuing our official statement regarding the content related to the video uploaded on a certain YouTube channel that is being mentioned on online communities and in the media. We have taken measures such as conducting a detailed check beginning with the time period mentioned in the YouTube video, and we found that the truth is entirely different from what is said in the video. After this, we sent an official request to the YouTube channel to delete the video, and the video has been deleted from the channel. Our agency plans to take a strong response in future to protect our artists' rights and interests in relation to the dissemination of false information and the act of spreading this, and we will show no leniency nor come to agreements. We thank everyone who loves JBJ95, and we will continue to do our best through continued monitoring and active response for the protection of our artists' rights and interests, as much as the amount that you cherish them. So reading Park Yun Ho's interview doon sa YouTube channel Idol Olympic, it breaks my heart kasi ito na naman, may isang case of somehow bullying and he was being ostracized and he was outcasted by his fellow members of Topp Dogg at the time. So to think that the way of the members of Topp Dogg voting if Seogoong or Park Hyun Ho should leave the group or not is just too much. Parang they have crossed the line kasi they felt like parang siya yung sagabal dun sa grupo. Although hindi sinabi kung sino yung mga members, hindi specify kung sino yung mga members na tumaas ng kamay upang umalis si Seogoong doon sa grupo. I mean, isn't it crossing the line already? And hindi lang yung girl groups yung may beef within each other. Let me tell you that. Pati yung mga boy groups meron din beef within each other. And I know that there are some boy groups na may konting conflict na nangyayari on screen. Yeah, it happened on screen sometimes. Pero pag off screen, well, it tells the entire different story talaga. Pero doon sa huling part ng kanyang interview, at least nag-improve yung relationship niya with the former members of Topp Dogg. Hopefully, pag magka-reunion yung mga former and current members of XENO-T, I hope that their relationship will fully improve. Unlike nung nangyari kay Park Hyun Ho when he was still a member of Topp Dogg. But at least we get to see kung ano talaga yung nangyayari behind the scenes noong sa isang boy group like Topp Dogg na underrated at hindi pinopromote masyadong ng maayos na mga, ng agency, I mean. And hopefully, this will serve as an eye-opener na hindi lahat ng mga groups ay friendly on screen. Because kung ano yung nakikita natin on screen, yung mga ugali nila, is not the same when the cameras turn off. So let me remind y'all to please examine yung mga movements ng mga members of various girl and boy groups carefully and see kung ano yung trato ng mga members sa isa't isa. Okay? At least, may mga variety shows that na ginagess yung mga idols or yung mga groups. And we need to see kung gaano kasincere or genuine, I mean, genuine yung friendship nila or yung bond as a team. And i-determine kung sino yung friendly or yung may genuine friendship or kung sino yung grupo na hindi genuine yung friendship. Because doon mo malalaman talaga kung alin na grupo is more hostile than the other group. So parang wina-warn ko kayo na you need to examine the groups carefully. At least makikita natin kung gaano totoo yung bond nila sa team and kung gaano, well, I should say, scripted yung trato nila sa isa't isa, not just in variety shows, but on music shows as well. Especially pag may nanalong group na nag-number one sa isang music show. So, parang palatandaan natin na we need to examine their movements carefully as time goes by. At least, malinawan natin na there are groups na totoo talaga yung band nila and there are groups na yung mga members ay may beef within each other. So I guess that's it for this video. Thank you so much and I know that it's late, pero happy 2021, people! I'll see you guys next time. Bye!